My name is Mara. I use she, her pronouns. And Jonah asked me to just share a little bit about myself today with you. And I was thinking about this all week. And then I have two small kids. My oldest is 5. His name's Grant. And he was at Vacation Bible School all week this week. And so he would come home and I would ask him, what did you learn today? What did you do today? And one of the stories that he learned really has sort of stuck with me. And that is, there is a story in the New Testament about two sisters, Martha and Mary, and, gosh, I'm real nervous. and Jesus is coming to visit them, and Martha is me. And Martha is worried and trying to make sure everything is perfect, and the house is put together, and her sister Mary is hanging out with Jesus. And the way that Grant was really excited about this story, because he said the picture in the kids' Bible book was Martha. She was dusting with this hand and cleaning a dish with this hand and stirring soup with her foot. And she was just crazy. And she was mad. She was mad at Mary, who was not helping. And I really relate to this. But in a way that I think is a little bit different than a lot of people talk about this story. And that is that in the story, Martha is mad at Mary for not helping. And I'm always doing everything. It's just who I am. It's sort of who I like to be. I like to help. I like to do all the things, help all the people, be busy all the time. If I'm sitting still, I feel nervous. But I also get mad at people who don't help me. But I think it's for reasons that people misunderstand. And that is because when I'm mad that someone is not helping, it's more about the fact that I feel like I'm not doing a good enough job putting everything together. I'm always just shy of perfect. And I don't want anybody to see the cracks that are forming in my perfect facade. I'm striving to be the perfect partner, the perfect mom. And so when I get mad at other people, it's not really that I'm mad at them. In the way that I'm pretty sure that Martha wasn't really mad at Mary. Martha wanted to be everything perfect for Jesus and felt like it wasn't. I want to have everything perfect for the people I love and for Jesus. And I feel like I fall short. This week was especially hard. I don't know why. Just because some weeks are harder than others. I didn't get to the grocery store, and so I didn't have enough food to cook dinner for my family last night. And I turned to my husband and I said, jokingly, I failed as a mother. And I meant it a little bit. And I don't want anyone to ever know that, which is bizarre that I'm telling you all today. But the interesting thing about this story, when Grant told me about what happened when Martha got mad at Mary and told Jesus, Jesus said in this kid's storybook Bible, they're both good. And that struck me in a new way this time, because it reminded me of the creation story when Jesus said, I made you and you are good. And I will tell you that it is, on some days, impossible for me to believe that. That I am good, even when I don't make dinner for my family. Or get the kids to all their things on time, or get all my work done at work, or call my mom by 9 o'clock on her birthday, or any of the many other things that I do wrong. But when I come here to Zach, you all tell me if I'm good. Every worship, someone gets up here and says, we want your whole self. And I can't tell you how important that's been to me. And I never thought it would be important. I thought that that was great for other people to hear because I've always felt comfortable at church. But it And you know what? The other thing I see around town is the Zao t-shirts. God made you perfect. When I see that and I read it, sometimes it helps me believe. God made me perfect. So I want you all to know that God made you perfect. And that you are good. And maybe on days when you don't believe, you'll believe just a little bit if I keep telling you. So please keep telling me so that I can remember. And I promise to keep telling you.